Breaking news tonight reports the woman at the centre of the scandal that triggered Tim Paine's tearful resignation has filed a sexual harassment lawsuit against Cricket Tasmania. This is unrelated to the Paine saga. It has been a turbulent week in Australian cricket.
He had tried to get ahead of the gathering storm.
I do not want this to become an unwelcome disruption to the team ahead of what is a huge Ashes series.
But the scandal itself, along with the backlash and the blame game that since engulfed Cricket Australia, has all taken a toll on Tim Paine.
It's a traumatic event for him. A week ago he was the Australian captain, so these things take time.
And today his manager confirmed the former captain
is stepping away from cricket for an indefinite mental health break. We're extremely concerned for his and Bonnie's well-being and will make no further comment at this time.
After 35 tests, 23 as captain, Paine's international career looks to be all but over. With the first test less than 2 weeks away, the scandal's made a mess of Australia's Ashes preparations and left Cricket Australia desperate for a distraction. Hey, look over here, a new captain. After days of deliberations, today's choice came down to 28-year-old Pat Cummins, squeaky clean fast bowling superstar.
I really like reading books.
And 32-year-old Steve Smith, former captain and eccentric batting genius.
I do some weird stuff.
While Cummins is a marketer's dream, some cricketing greats do have reservations about his workload with the bat and ball across three formats.
I always found it was easier as a batsman, particularly he doesn't bowl much, to be a captain. Who's if they're all available, I'd choose Steve Smith.
Would you really?
I really would.
But given the way things ended for Smith last time...
I know I'll regret this for the rest of my life.
Selectors decided to break with tear-stained, scandal-plagued recent tradition.
I look forward to doing everything that I can in my power to help Patrick.
Might look a little bit different from the outside to potentially other captains in the past, and that's great.
Pat Cummins, come on down.
Now, before news of the lawsuit broke, we caught up with Australia's 47th Test captain a little earlier. Firstly, massive congratulations to you. How does it feel being Australian Test captain heading into the Ashes?
It's been amazing, 24 hours or so for me. Incredible feeling. Brings me straight back to my childhood, that little kid running around the backyard. It's really special.
I mean, as a fast bowler, did you imagine, though, that you would be Australia's Test captain one day? Because it's pretty rare for fast bowlers to become Test captains.
No, never. I suppose it became a little bit more front of mind the last couple of years since being vice-captain. But when you hear about the history, I think it's been 60-odd years since a bowling captain, makes it a little bit more special too.
Given what's happened to the last two captains, did you need any convincing to take the job?
It's certainly front of mind. Seeing two really good mates go through what they went through after giving so much to cricket and leading the group. Yeah, I've had some really good chats with a couple of the CA directors, and Paney's been great to speak to as well. So added responsibilities and scrutiny that come with this job, but there's so many positives which I'm really excited about.
You mentioned Tim Paine is a good mate of yours, and you said you've been in touch. I'm interested to know what the feedback was from him, what the advice is going into this, given everything that has happened.
Mostly our conversations is just making sure he's okay. We care deeply about Tim and his family, and he said, let's loop back around nearer to the test. I'll be certainly picking his brain over a few of the finer points of captaincy, but no, he's been great. Just gave his support and said, you're ready for this and back yourself.
Obviously, you're not just captain now, you're kind of chief diplomat as well, so I'm sure you want to be careful with everything you say going forward. But given all the human lives involved in this kind of pretty messy saga, just on a human level, do you think it should have been handled better?
With this role comes such huge responsibilities, and I think at times it's quite unrealistic. We're all humans, we're all flawed, and I think at times we need to be kinder to each other.
How much time have you spent thinking back through everything you said, done, texted, tweeted, argued in your adult lifetime before making this decision to accept the gig?
Yeah, I mean, a little bit. I won't lie. I think, you're your own harshest critic, about how you want to live your life. And I've made mistakes in the past. I've probably upset people in the past. But I think it's shaped who I am today. And I think what helps is looking around and seeing some really experienced teammates who I've known for a long time. That'll be great helps for me. And, you know, we're lucky these days. We've got a huge support staff. So that gives me a lot of comfort. Overall, I'm really excited for it.
Pat, the eyes of the nation are on you. Everyone wants to know about you. You've mentioned that your interests include books, podcasts and documentaries. Do you think the fact that you are a massive nerd will influence the way that you captain?
I have my moments. I try and sound a lot smarter than I actually am. but, yeah, no, there's a few closet nerds in the team at the moment. JL, the coach, he's a big nerd. He's always got about 10 books he's carrying around.
I feel like you're trying to pass the nerd buck here, Pat. Is that what's going on? All right, Pat, well, thank you so much for your time and congratulations again on becoming our cricket captain.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Good luck to him. Good luck to the team. So I think when you listen to that, you realise how much pressure is on an individual's shoulders when they take on a role like this. But it certainly looks and sounds like they've made the right choice.
Yeah, and if you put all of the controversy aside of recent times, it is a really exciting day for Pat Cummins.
Amazing day.